Coming to you live from the studios in the Tiger Performance Complex, this is the Missouri Gymnastics News Network. Hello and welcome to MGNN. I'm your host, Scotty Mack. On today's show, we check out the Tigers intro video. We will also chat with a couple of the coaches. But first, here are your Missouri gymnastics headlines. Friday night at the Hearn Center, the 8th-ranked University of Missouri gymnastics team hosted the number 4 Alabama Crimson Tide in their annual Pinkout meet. Missouri freshman Aspen Tucker won the all-around competition with a score of 39.325. This was Tucker's highest career all-around score. Mizzou would go on to score a 195.5 in the meet. Starting out on vault, Tucker would lead off with a score of 9.85. while Kennedy Harris and Madeline Huber scored 9.825s. Sophomore Brittany Ward went on to win with a score of 9.95. This is not only a career best for Ward, but it ties for the 4th highest vault score in school history. Ward competes a Yurchenko half-on front pike. Last week, her vault against Arkansas was nominated for Routine of the Week by BalanceBeamSituation.com. On bars, it was Morgan Porter who led the way with a 9.85. Tucker would score a career-high 9.825, while junior Shauna Miller scored a 9.775. The Tigers took to the beam in the third rotation, where 5 of the gymnasts would score 9.8 or better. Ward and sophomore Brooke Kelly led the squad with a pair of 9.875s. Juniors Tia Albritton and Becca Schugel, along with freshman Tucker, all tallied a 9.8 on the event. On the final rotation, Harris led the Tigers with a huge 9.9. Tucker claimed another career best with a score of 9.85, and sophomore Allison Bauer would score a 9.8 to help the team earn a 49.075 event score. This week, the Missouri gymnastics team is ranked 11th in the NCAA. The team has maintained a top 15 ranking since being ranked 19th in the preseason poll. This Friday, the Tigers travel to Athens, Georgia to face the number 16 Georgia Bulldogs. The meet will be live on the SEC Network at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Here with head coach Shannon Welker. Thanks for coming in today, and great job this weekend. What routines really stuck out for you?
Yeah, I thought we had so many great routines. You know, first off, before we even get to routines, I was so impressed with the electricity in the crowd and just our fan support this weekend. It was incredible. It was really, really exciting.
Definitely one of your biggest crowds, I think, you've had as, you know, a coach here.
Absolutely, absolutely. But back to really good routines from the weekend. I thought we had a lot of highlights. I think in particular, I was very impressed with Brittany Ward did a great job on vault this weekend. I thought second weekend in a row, really nice. I thought Aspen Tucker did a real nice job in our leadoff position on bars. I thought Brooke Kelly looked real sharp on beam this weekend. And I had a lot of floor routines that I thought made really nice improvements. I was impressed. Allison Bauer did a great job, and she was out, really didn't do any training for the week, kind of had a pulled little bit of an ab muscle that was giving her a little trouble, and she was feeling better come meet day, and she hopped up there and led us off so strong. So that was really impressive from a mental toughness standpoint. And then I liked Aspen Tucker in the 2 spot, and then and I thought Kennedy Harris closed us out real strong too.
Yeah, 9.9 on floor, great score for Kennedy. You mentioned improvements. What specific improvements did you notice this week?
Yeah, I thought, from some things we were working on from last week, moving into this week, I thought we started our first event really strong, which is something we want to make sure we're doing. So vault went really well again this week. I thought we did a much better job on hitting handstands on bars. And I thought we did a noticeable change in our tempo, in our rhythm, in our jumps on beam. So I thought that was really nice too.
That's excellent. Mm-hmm. Now, third road meet of the year coming up. It's early in the season and you've already been to 3 away meets. How does the team handle the away meets? They have school now, classes mm-hmm. have started. What kind of comforts do you give them, traveling, buses, hotels, right, et cetera, to kind of get them ready to handle those away meets?
Yeah, we do these when we travel. We try to make it as comfortable as possible because we know they're busy and we ask a lot of them, excellence in the gym, excellence in the classroom. So we do a couple of charter flights a year where we just fly our team on it and our staff, which makes makes it really nice getting to and from. We can get home the night after a competition, which is, it's so nice to sleep in your own bed as much as possible, especially during season. When we take buses, we take some nice charter sleeper buses that have bunks in them so we can actually sleep while we're moving from place to place as well. They have Wi-Fi so they can get homework done. So a lot of just different areas where we can make sure that they're being efficient with their time and getting great grades too.
So a lot more goes into it than meets the eye.
Absolutely.
Well, thanks for joining us today and good luck in Athens.
All right. Thanks, Scott.
Welcome to Sparkles and Spandex with assistant coach Casey Joe McPherson. How are you doing, coach?
Doing great. How about you?
Doing excellent. Thanks for coming in.
Good.
Now, second pink meet in a row, and this one in Georgia is actually a pink and green meet. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes. So Georgia wanted to do a pink and green meet. For the pink is to support breast cancer, and then the green is actually for all other cancers.
And anything exciting the girls are going to be doing for the green part of this meet?
Well, we'll be wearing our pink Leo again that we wore at our home pink meet, but then we're also going to, I think the team's going to wear some green bows in their hair, and then we're also going to look into getting green glitter for their hair and their tiger head.
So. Not a lot of people know, but a lot of glitter goes into gymnastics. I mean, it's something I never realized until, you know, you get up close and you see all the sparkles on their face.
It's true. You know, this segment is Sparkles and Spandex, so, you know, it's fun for them. It's just part of looking good and feeling good and feeling like you are, you know, you sparkle out there, so.
Look good, feel good, compete good, right?
That's right.
Well, thanks for coming in and good luck this weekend.
Thank you very much.
That's all for this week on MGNN. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to like our video and share it. Until next time, M-I-Z!